Good morning. Welcome to day two of my winter trip. As you can hear, it's precipitating. Now, if you remember last night, I said that the forecast was saying it was going to start snowing after midnight. Well, I checked my watch just shortly after this started. It was 12:05. Yeah, and it's been precipitating off and on ever since. Mostly on. It's sounding like rain hitting the tent, but then it is accumulating on the tent, tarp, whatever. And I've been knocking it off like that all night so it wouldn't accumulate. So, I don't know if it's freezing rain or just very wet snow. Whatever it is, it's kind of a mess. And it's going to be a struggle getting out of here. Out of my sleeping bag, getting dressed, all that kind of good stuff. My body stayed nice and warm last night, all through the night. No problems with that, but my feet kept getting cold. So I don't know what's up with that. I was wearing socks. I eventually kicked those socks off and put the socks on that I was wearing last thing yesterday. They're a little bit warmer than they were, but not by much. Toes are still cold. Anyway, it's going to be a long struggle to get out of this, get dressed, get out of the sleep bag. Sorry about that. It's about 20 to 8 right now. I got to start moving. It's going to take me probably half an hour, 45 minutes to do this. Later. Okay, while I'm waiting for the water to boil, I thought I'd run through some of what I'm wearing. I'll start from my head. I'm wearing a hoodie, a fleece hoodie. I could also wear it as a fleece warmer or a neck warmer. I can pull it up. My nose starts getting cold. Actually, right now, I'm sweating to death, so I'm probably going to pull this off pretty soon. Put a regular knit hat on, but anyway. That I can't really give you any information on. They look like they'd be fairly easy to make for yourself. But I was at a show in a mall somewhere. I don't even remember where now. Telling my art at a show, and this guy came by the booth with a bunch of these, selling them. Can't remember how much it was at the time, less than $10, probably more like about $5 or so. So I thought it was a good deal, and it definitely does the job. It's a little bit oversized, is all. I think I would have wanted something that was a little bit more form-fitting than what this is, but it's okay. Then for a jacket right now, I'm wearing a down jacket I got from Cabela's. It was probably on sale at one time, otherwise I wouldn't have bought it probably. I've had it for many years. I don't remember when I bought it, circumstances. I know it was back when I had money, when I had a day job and therefore money. But it's really nice on the really cold winter days. A little bit of a overkill today, but there again, I might change it out for my other jacket in a little while. Underneath that, before I start talking about this, I have a fleece shirt on, button-up shirt. Probably got it from Camp Moore, but I don't know for sure. Again, I've had it for many years, and I don't remember the details. I've got a couple of them. Underneath that, I have a pair. I have a Polypro undershirt, and my water is boiling, so I'm going to put you down for a minute and see about getting some breakfast going. Breakfast this morning, by the way, is peaches and cream oatmeal. Surprise, surprise, not maple and brown. In fact, actually, I didn't bring any maple and brown sugar on this trip. Okay, continuation of what I'm wearing. Oops, let me unzip this all the way. Okay, first of all, my outer layer here is a set of Arctics. I don't know, I can't see what you're looking at, so I hope I'm putting this right. Arctics bib overalls, bib snow pants. I just bought these recently. I got them from Camp Moore for $29.99. They are the cat's meow, let me tell you. I had these things on all day yesterday. From the time I left the parking lot to the time I went to bed last night, I had these on. They were super. Let's see if I can zip them down far enough here. I'm not going to show you too many layers here, but under them I've got a pair of fleece pants. Probably again Camp Moore many years ago. Under there I've got Polypro liners that match my shirt. And then on my feet I have we have these mukluks made by Cook Custom Sewing. See the label over here. See? Cook Custom Sewing. Again, I've had these for many years. I love them. My feet do get a little bit cold in them, especially on the bottoms. They are oversized. He makes them so that you can put them over ski boots or whatever, which is, you know, I was trying to wear them without any boots underneath, which is probably why they weren't doing a good job. But what I've done for this trip is I took the liners out of a pair of Sorel knockoffs, and I'm wearing them inside the mukluks, so my feet are staying warmer, but they are nice. Show you another feature of this Arctex bib snow pants is that they have this liner on the inside at the bottom that's got elastic at the bottom of it, so you can stick that down inside your boot or whatever, and then you can pull the
snowpant down over that, so it's almost like having built-in gaiters. And base layer underneath all that, the mucklucks and everything, is just a pair of wool. Well, they're not wool, they're all synthetic, but wool-like socks, heavy winter socks. So there you have it. That's what I'm wearing at the moment. Probably not going to keep this down jacket or this fleece hoodie on for much longer, because I am absolutely roasting to death in them, which is not good. Is moisture management and everything like that. Another thing to tell you about is when I got the bib overalls, bib snow pants, whatever you want to call them. Camp Moore has a free shipping if you buy over $50 worth of items. And I had been thinking about buying a pair of winter gloves anyway. So I kind of did some digging around on winter gloves. And I came up with these Gordini Gore-Tex gloves. They were on sale for like $39.99. Normally like $69 something or another. Something like that. So, I thought that was a good deal. It put me over the $50 with no problem. And tried them out yesterday. I didn't put them on until I got to camp, when all my other gloves were all soaked and everything. These have been sitting in the cold. My fingers were starting to get, well, they were definitely wet from sweat, and they were starting to get cold themselves. And I stuck them in these gloves, and it was almost instant warmth in these things. And a lot of times you have to warm up the gloves a little bit. These were, even though they've been sitting out in the cold, it was instant warmth. So, of course, being gloves like this, they don't have a lot of dexterity to them. Hence why I have to take them off to do stuff. Oh, I should say, even my fingers were warm in these. I didn't even have to ball up my hands to keep my fingers warm. The fingers of the gloves were keeping my fingers warm. They were just some fantastic gloves. Something I might show you later. I also, when I was in Walmart the other day buying stuff for this trip, outfitting myself for this trip, I came across a pair of convertible mitts, you know, the kind that they're kind of a glove and a mitt, so you take the end of the mitt off, and they looked nice and warm. They're made by the warm hands, you know, the people that make those inserts that you put in the hot hands inserts that you put into side of gloves. They looked really, really nice and warm. They felt nice and warm in the store. Before I put these on yesterday, I tried a pair of those hot hand gloves with hot hands insert inside, and they were doing absolutely nothing for my hands. So if you come across those in Walmart, don't bother. They look nice and warm. They look like the cat's meow. They are not. So anyway, been talking enough now. My oatmeal's ready to eat. I don't have my good camera out where I can do my oatmeal talk this morning. So you're getting a pre-oatmeal talk instead. So I'm gonna eat my oatmeal and probably be back.
Well, I sure can eat my oatmeal a lot faster when I'm not talking to you guys with every spoonful. And especially when I'm ravenous like I was this morning. Definitely did not eat enough last night. Anyway, I've learned two lessons on this trip so far. Actually, kind of common sense things anyway, but lesson number one, if you have a choice, if you're melting snow for water, as I am, do not collect your snow in the woods. Get all kinds of stuff off the trees and that snow, and no matter how careful you try to be, you get stuff in it. And believe me, I had a lot of stuff in my water last night because that's exactly what I did. And it flavored everything that I made with it, and just wasn't all that delightful. So what I started doing after that, it's a good track down to the lake, especially up and down that hill. But I've been collecting my water, I've been collecting my snow, I should say, off the top of the lake, the snow that's on the lake. Go out there away from shore a little ways so I get away from all those droppings and everything. It's still not perfectly clean snow, but it's a lot cleaner than what I found underneath the underneath the trees. And lesson number two, when you put your pot down in the morning, do not put it on the bare snow, or if you do, wipe the snow off the bottom of the pot before you put it on your stove. I didn't do that this morning. I put the pot down in the snow, put it right on the stove, did okay for a while, and then all of a sudden all that snow turned to water and actually put my stove out, and I had a little bit of trouble getting it back started again. So don't do that. A lot better to wipe it off or set it down somewhere where the bottom's not gonna get covered with snow. Anyway, two words of wisdom, or two items of wisdom for today. I'm getting a little bit concerned here. This is a full tank of propane when I came out yesterday. And you know, I've been doing a lot of snow melting and water boiling and what have you. But this tank is almost gone already. Just after last night and this morning. So, and I only have one more tank. I may not be able to make it through 3 days unless I cook over wood, assuming that I get some wood. I could be hurting here. I have decided I'm going to see about setting up my tent. I just need my headroom too much for getting in and out of the sleeping bag. I mean, everything was okay last night once I got in the sleeping bag. Other than, like I said, my toes were cold, but tent probably isn't going to fix that. I think I need to put a different pair of socks on than what I did last night. But the problem is, not having any headroom for doing all the changing I do before going to bed and after I get up, or when I get up in the morning. So I'm going to see about setting up my tent. Probably going to set it up right in this area here. When I've done that, what I might do, I'm not sure if I'm going to leave the tarp where it is. I'm going to have to check the forecast again and see if they're predicting more snow. If they predict more snow, then I might actually set up my tarp as a tarp back pretty much in the same area here. And
That way I'll have a place I can sit under, especially with this wet snow. It's almost like being rained on. But the other thing I need to do today is I need to get some firewood. I absolutely have to get firewood and be able to start a fire, especially if I'm going to have to cook over a fire, which I may end up having to do, because this stove is really going through the fuel. So all in all, it's going to be a busy day, so I doubt very much that I'm going to be able to do the hike that I was planning on doing today. Oh, boy, the snow is deep. I might have to put my... I might have to get my snowshoes back on so I can get the snow back down for my tent to go on. These mucklucks are sinking down too much. Of course, the other thing I can do possibly is use my toboggan. That's what I can do. This area all smoothed out and everything, I'm going to try not to walk on it, because that's a somewhat level place to sleep now. I'm going to try to set the tent up without walking on the bed area there. See how it goes. This is a tent I got from Cabela's quite a few years ago. I have used it in the Boundary Waters before. I just prefer having the two man along. It gives me a lot more room. But I thought, I do like the fact that this has got aluminum poles instead of the fiberglass that my Eureka has. Especially for cold weather, it's nice to have the aluminum, because they tend to hold up to the cold temperatures better than fiberglass. Not that I've ever had problems with fiberglass, but I know some people have. Nice thing about this tent is there's no sleeves, it's all clips. Can't remember whether orange goes first or blue goes first. I'm gonna do one. I don't know, maybe it doesn't make any difference. The orange and blue designation is basically to show you where the clips go.
Been a long time since I've used this tent. It's a lot less expensive than our Eureka. Last time I looked in the Cabela's, they didn't have them anymore. Okay, I didn't make my bed quite long enough for this. Underestimated the size of it. Here, now we got it. Now I gotta before I put the fly on, it's gonna make it easier to put some of this other stuff inside first. Also, what was happening last night was that my thermarest kept trying to slide out the bottom of the tarp. I had to wake up once in a while and pull it back up again. So, another reason, if it slides here, it's just going to go to the end of the tent and no further. Now, for tonight, I'm going to use my 15 degree bag because it's only supposed to get down into the high teens, low 20s tonight. But I am going to have my liner handy. That's right, I haven't talked about this liner yet to you guys. That comes with the October Boundary Waters trip. I'll probably be posting this before that, so I'll have more detail in that video about it, but it's basically a lightweight liner that's supposed to add up to 15 degrees to your sleeping bag. Tried it out a couple of times and it seems to work okay. And a lot lighter to carry around than the and less bulky than the fleece sleeping bag I used to carry with me all the time, just in case I needed it. And then really hot weather, I can use the liner by itself. Just a few more things to put in here, and then I'll be putting the thing on top, the fly. I'm not going to bother staking down the corners of the tent. I think I'm going to be okay without them staked down, but I am going to have to stake down the fly, and especially the vestibule. I'm going to be needing to use that. Well, it's 11 o'clock. I have the tent set up now, and it's time for a little sit-down rest break here. Did I say the sun was out? Did I say it was 11 o'clock? I can't remember what I said and what I didn't say now. Anyway, I'm going to sit down for a little while, have some water, and decide whether I want to get going on wood or whether I want to get going on Well, I have my tarp set up now. Not the most professional job I've ever done, but it's going to be adequate. It will be a place where I can sit if it starts sleeting again, which it might do Saturday night, Sunday morning. So yeah, got that set up, my tent's up there. Could almost have set up the tent underneath the fly, but now that I have the tent set up up there, I'm not moving. Sorry. It's just gonna have to stay there. So yeah, tarp. There's the lake down there through the trees. Maybe eventually today I'll have to do some pictures. I hate to trade those nice warm mukluks for a pair of cold boots, but if I'm gonna go out and get wood, I'm gonna need to wear snowshoes, and I can't wear snowshoes with the mukluks. They only work with these boots. Well, at least I'm keeping the same pair of warm socks on in any case, so that helps. These are my bugga boots that I got last March or April after my other ones that I'd had for many years failed, started splitting. Time to go off and try to find some wood.
Well, I have a little bit more wood. Doubt that it's enough for two fires, but it's better than what I had last night. I'm gonna have to process it now, of course. See what it looks like after I get it processed. But I'm exhausted. Can't go and get any more yet. Okay, I don't know how much this is going to show up, but I cut my circle around my fire grate a little bit bigger so that, I mean, before it was so small that my feet were right by the grill, and now I can sit a little bit further away. It kind of tapers a little bit over this way, so if I want to get closer, I can get there. I've also built up a little bit of a wall behind it to use as a reflector, hopefully. So, yeah. Now all I have to do is make sure I can start a fire. So I haven't cut any wood yet. Got to do it now. Or I should say, I haven't processed any wood yet.
remember last night when I said I had a surprise this morning for you this afternoon, today? Well, here it is. I cooked up some chicken fettuccine tonight. It's a pasta side. It's not freeze-dried.
Well,
yum yum.
I don't think I'm going to have a fire tonight. I've been spending all my time, well, I ate, and I had quite a bit to eat, so it took me a while to do that. Then I had cleanup to do, and now I'm sitting down with a cup of hot chocolate, but I've been constantly having to boil up water for this, that, and the other. I actually had to change cylinders tonight, which has me worried. Because again, I only brought two cylinders, so hopefully this one I started up tonight lasts me a little bit longer. But all this making water from snow and boiling it up and all the rest of it, taking a lot of taking a lot of my energy, taking a lot of propane to do. So I'm not sure what time it is now. 10 to 8. I figured by the time I had a fire, got it started and everything, it'd be time for me to think about going to bed, because didn't sleep very well last night. Had a long day today. Had a tough day today. Thinking back on it, I'm not quite sure what I did. I know I set up the tent, reset the tarp, gathered firewood, boiled water, boiled more water, had supper, took a few pictures, did a lot of resting, I know, in between stuff, but it seems like I've been constantly on the go all day today, and I don't know. I just don't have energy to mess with a fire tonight. So maybe, just maybe, I'll use that wood tomorrow night. It's kind of finale. Hopefully tomorrow I'll be able to get out on the trails a little bit. Hopefully down to the river. Not sure if I'll make it or not. Tough trails around here. Not a lot of people have used them. So I'm not sure how far I'll get, because it takes a lot of energy plowing through the snow, even on snowshoes. So anyway, I think this is probably it for tonight. I might do one more check-in when I'm in bed. Don't know for sure. I'll have to see how things go. So talk to you later.